pag static, pag dynamic.
Dahil marami kayong nire-request na tanong-tanong kung okay ba tong fund na to, okay ba tong investment na to.
Okay.
Kayo po ay aming pinagbigyan.
Ano yung didiscuss natin ngayon?
Mutual fund. It's one of the mutual funds in the market right now. Okay, from ATR Asset Management. Yan. And they call it the ATRAM Dynamic Allocation Fund. Dynamic.
Oh. So, ano ba yung ATRAM Dynamic Allocation Fund?
Okay, yan? First and foremost, ano siya? It's a mutual
fund. Ano ba yung ATRAM muna?
ATRAM, it's a standalone trust corporation. So, ano siya? It's a trust company dito sa Philippines. Dati siyang ATR Kim Eng. Tapos, nag-ano na siya, nag-solo na siya. Yun. So, nag-ATR Asset Management.
So, it's a investment company.
Yeah, na meron siyang mutual fund, nag-offer siya ng mutual fund, tapos nag-offer din siya ng UITF. Pero dito na tayo sa UITF kasi parang mga 20 lahat ng funds nila eh. hindi kaya ng powers nila.
So, well, like most investment companies or financial institutions like this, they carry a lot of products.
Yeah.
They carry a lot of...
parang bibilang yan.
Ayun. Yeah. So, they have a lot of mutual funds and UITF. And for today, you are going to tell us about the ATRAM Dynamic Allocation Fund Incorporated.
Right. And this is as of March 28. So basically, it is a balanced fund.
A balanced fund siya.
Oh, dynamic. But ang difference niya, kasi usually kasi sa market, pag balanced fund, 50-50.
Okay.
50 stocks, 50 bonds.
Yes.
But since it's dynamic, allocation
ganun,
fund.
Dynamic.
nagsiswing siya.
So,
kumbaga,
okay,
kung
gets.
Tingin...
Bigla akong nag-gets yung ba't siya dynamic.
Oh,
okay.
Ang galing eh. So, kung tingin ni fund manager na malakas ang stock market, medyo totoo doon
sa stock. Dadamihan niya yung stocks.
Para maka-rise siya ng stock market.
Oh.
Tapos kung tingin niya magkocorrect na yung market, or tingin niya pababa ang market, magpababa siya.
So, dadamihan niya yung bonds, tama ba?
Or... Yeah, dadamihan yung bonds or corollarily, babawas siya ng stocks.
Okay, okay.
Not necessarily dadamihan yung bonds kasi pwede magbawas ka ng stocks, nasa cash ka lang eh.
Gets. Yeah. Basta, pag sa tingin niya magkocorrect ang market, babawasan niya yung stock holdings niya.
Or kung tingin niya topish na, kung tingin niya medyo peak na, magpo-profit take siya. So, kumbaga, it's very proactive.
Oo.
Yeah, hindi lang sa 50-50.
Pero merong limit yung pagka-dynamic niya.
Oh, they call it the strategic asset allocation.
Okay.
So, usually, some balance, minsan mga 60%, mga...
Yun ay maximum.
May mga maximum.
Hindi pero niya gagawing 90% stocks.
Hindi, kasi equity fund na yun.
So, itong particular na itong dynamic
itong
allocation fund.
Itong particular dynamic allocation fund, as of March 28, nasa ano siya, 55% equities. 30% stocks. So, tingin ko as of this date, medyo nag-ano na siya. Medyo nagbawas na siya ng equities. Feeling ko na profit take na to.
Kaya kasi medyo malaki yung cash, no?
Oo, cash is 12%. Which is good kasi is from cash. March hanggang ngayon, bumaba yung market. So, maaga to nag-profit take.
Okay.
Parang medyo think ko na foresee nila.
Okay, so what else can you say about that?
Well, since inception, it has been here since 2007. So, matagal na rin.
Okay. 11 years.
11 years. And since inception, it has already given, tumas na siya ng 70.7%.
Okay. So, kung noong 2007, naglagay ako ng 100,000. Ngayon, 170,000 na siya.
Pwede na. And, lumalabas, on a per year basis. Kasi yung, yung 70%.
Cumulative yan eh.
Cumulative yun.
So, yung CAGR?
yung CAGR, hindi. Per year.
Okay.
Per year, 2012, 25%. Pwede na. 2013, 8.3%. 2014, 10.95%. 2015, bumaba siya ng 10%.
Uh-huh.
2016, also bad for minus 4%. But 2017, 11%.
So,
and 2018 hanggang...
So, year-to-date yan, I think.
Year-to-date niya, as of that date, nasa minus 5%.
Oo.
But ever since from 2007 is 70%. So kumbaga, it's a fund.
Kaya nga balance, di ba?
Oh.
It will grow, but not that much.
Oh.
But it will also not be negative na gano'ng kalaki.
Oh, oh. Na stock market. Oh. Saka kung titingnan mo kung how many years, no, kung from 2012, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 years, out of the 7 years, 3 times lang siya nag-down.
Oo.
So kumbaga, kung titingnan mo probability wise, hindi ka talaga basta long term ka.
Oo, basta long term ka.
The benefits outweigh the risk.
Yes.
Kasi mas malaki yung up na years kesa dun sa down years.
Ah, okay.
Yan. Meron din siya nakalagay dito. Medyo technical kasi yung ATR asset.
Ano yung binabasa mo yan?
Ito yung kanilang ano, ito yung kanilang fact sheet.
Oh.
With a fact sheet.
FACT.
Yes.
Fact sheet.
Ito, percentage of positive months. Ah, may portfolio analytics siya. 60% of all its months is positive siya. Okay, so ibig sabihin, 60% of the time, it's up.
Ah, alright.
Okay,
that's
tapos,
good.
Average gain in positive months, kumbaga, 2.28.
28.
Oh, 28%. So, kumbaga, parang it's as if, gumagain ka ng 2.28% per month on the average.
Uh-huh.
Oh, which is pwede na.
So, saan mo nakuha yung fact sheet na yan?
Itong fact sheet na to, nakuha ko sa kanilang website.
Ah, okay.
Na ilalagay natin dyan if you wanna know more about this fund.
Okay.
And yeah, management fee, 175%. Pero ano na to, yung price per share, yung net asset value per share niya is ano na.
Okay. So, siguro, ito na yung last question ko dyan sa yes. ATRAM Dynamic Allocation Fund na yan. Kailan ako mag-invest?
Ah, okay. Kung ang tingin...
Kung
ako,
ang financial goal ko ay...
Medium term.
Which
if
is...
you need the money in 5 to 10 years time,
uh-huh.
Lagay mo dito.
Pwede dyan ilagay. So, ano ba yung ini-expect kong mangyayari sa pera ko within that 5 to 10 years? Ayan, nahulog.
Oo, okay. Nahulog siya. Well, of course, it is market-driven.
So,
we cannot really make...
Sabi natin modest returns.
Siguro mga 5 to 7, I would hazard.
5 to 7%? KGAR.
KGAR.
So 5 to 7% your money will grow 5 to 7% per year. Given that you can invest with a time horizon of around 5 to 10 years. Yun yung magiging average growth.
Oh, the average. Of course it can change depending
sa market
conditions, but a typical balance fund would give you that. Pero
okay.
Ano pa lang yun, conservative pa lang. It can outperform.
Okay. So paano sila mag-invest diyan sa ATRAM na yan?
Ah, okay. They can go to the website of ATR Asset Management or they can email us para we can guide you also on how to invest in this particular fund.
Alright, sige. So, I hope may natutunan kayo today. And if you have other investment funds or investment products that you would like us to
or
have to
insurance.
Take a look or any financial product.
Yeah, any financial product.
Na gusto nyong pag-usapan namin, then you can just email us at admin@wealtharchy.com.
Yep.
And then please like and share this video. If you would like to receive more videos like this, then please subscribe to our channel and click the bell for the notification button. Alright, sige. So, bye-bye and see you next week.